What's up internet, welcome back once again. I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. In the last PL SQL tutorial, we learned that we can create nested table collection either as a part of PL SQL block or as a database collection object. We did the example on former as well as learned how to create nested table in PL SQL block along with the necessary theory. Today, in this tutorial, we will learn how to create PL SQL nested table as database collection object in Oracle Database. So without wasting your precious time, I will start right away. As database collection object, you can base your nested table either on primitive data type or on user defined data type. Let's see how. Here, after setting the server output on, we created our collection type, which is of course a nested table. The syntax of creating a nested table as database object is very similar to creating a nested table with PL SQL block. To create this nested table, we used our old and trusty createTypeDTL statement. It starts with the keyword create and is followed by an optional or replace clause. In this statement, this optional clause looks for the type with the same name, that is my nested table. If it finds any, then it changes its definition according to the statement, otherwise it creates one for you. Next, we have another keyword type, which indicates what kind of database object we are creating, followed by the name of your type, which in our case is my nested table. Then we have a reserved phrase isTable of, using which you indicate the data type of the elements which your table will hold. Here we use a primitive data type for creating our nested table, which is varchar2. You can use user defined data type as well. Anyways, let's execute this create type statement and create our nested table. Type my nested table compiled and created. If you have watched my last tutorial, then you must have noticed that it is the same nested table we created in that tutorial, except this time we created it as a standalone database object rather than a part of any PL SQL block. By standalone, I mean this object is stored inside your database permanently, that is, you can reuse it whenever you want. So let's move ahead and learn how to put this nested table to some use. Let's first close this script output. Okay.
And now you've got yourself something funky.
The collection type which we created above can be used to specify the type of a column of a table. And that is exactly what we did here. I created a simple table with name my subject. This table has three columns that are subject ID, which has data type number, subject name with data type varchar2, and subject schedule day. This column is of nested table type column. It means that this last column can hold multiple values. It could be 2 or 3 or maybe more, as nested table is an unbounded type of collection. In order to make any column a nested table type, you need to tell your compiler two things. First, the name of the column you want to use as a nested table column, and second, the storage table for your nested table type column. You do both these works using nested table and store as clause. Let's see how. You specify both these clause right after the closing parenthesis of createTableDDL statement. You first write the clause nested table followed by the name of the column that you declared as nested table, which in our case is sub_schedule_day. Then you write clause store as. Followed by store as clause, you have to specify the name of a storage table. This is a user defined name and could be anything. Let's call it nested tab space. And then you put the statement terminator. Now this DDL is complete. The successful execution of this DDL will create a table which has a column of nested table type in which we can store multiple values. Before moving ahead, I want to ask you one question. Remember the first form of normalization, which says there must not be a column in any row of a table with multiple values stored in it. The question is that if we should not save multiple values in a column, then why nested tables? What are the benefits of nested tables? Go ahead and comment down below to tell me your views on it. Meanwhile, let's execute this query and create this table. Table created successfully. You can use describe command and check the structure of the table like this. Here is the structure of our table. Now let's try to insert some rows into this table. One row inserted. Let's insert one more row. Another row inserted successfully. As you can see, we inserted two rows. Both of them have different number of values for the last column sub_schedule_t. You can check those values by executing select statement on the table. As the last column is of nested table type, thus its values are displayed in a certain way. Note here, the above tables which I created have no constant or index or anything created on them. I created them just to explain the concept of how to create nested table type collection in as easy as possible way. To understand above insert statements in greater detail along with other DML statements on nested table type, please visit my blog on the same topic. Link is in the description. With that being said, let's wind up today's tutorial. In today's tutorial, we learned how to create nested table type collection based on primitive data type. Stay tuned, as in the next tutorial, we will learn another way of creating nested table, but this time using user-defined data type. Please do make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also, please share this video. It will be a huge help to me and my channel. And if you are new to my channel, then please do consider subscribing. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.